design. In previous class, we have completed up to shapes. Today we are going to see the next topic, edges and corners of the shape. Do you have any idea about edges and corners of the shape? Now I will show one example for you. See, what shape is this? This is cube. Cube has how many faces? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then 6. Cube has 6 faces. First we are going to see edges. Edges means the line segment between two faces. The line segment between two faces. That is called edges. What is mean by corner? When two edges meet at one point, that is called corner. See, when two edges, this is one edge and this one is another edge. The two edges meet at one point, that is called corner. This is edges. Now I complete this figure. This is a square shape. In square shape, how many edges and corners? See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 edges. Next, corners. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 corners. Now, opening a group, I briefly explain about edges and corners of the shape.
Now, open your book to page number 63. Edges and corners. Meeta and her 5 friends were playing a game. Tinku was blindfolded and asked to keep clapping as long as he wished, while the others would move around the table. The moment Tinku stopped clapping, everybody would stop wherever they were. The children who was not at the corner would be out. Then she would be blindfolded. Okay. See, he is a boy Tinku. He is a blindfolded. And as to clapping, the moment Tinku stopped clapping, everybody would stop wherever they were. Okay. Now, Tinku stopped clapping. Everyone standing in their places. See, Chotu, and then Raja, Meeta, Banti, Gundu. Okay. Looking at the picture given above, can you tell who is out? See, who was not at a corner, that person is a out person. Who is not at a corner? Yes, Gundu. So, who is out? Gundu. Where Gundu is standing? Stand. Gundu is standing middle of the table. Can this game be played around table? Why? Can this game be played around a round table? Why? We can't play the game in a round table because the round table has no corners. The round table has no corners. Many things around us have straight edges. For example, see in the book, we have straight edges. On chair, we have straight edges. On kite, we have straight edges. We have two types of edges, straight edges and curved edges. Okay. Now turn the next page. Other things have curved edges. For example, wheel, plate. These two have the curved edges. Next, look around you and identify the things with straight and curved edges. See, straight edges, table, chair. Curved edges, wheel, egg. Do the things with the straight edges have corners? Yes. The things with the straight edges have corners. Yes, the things with straight edges have corner. Next, do the things with curved edges have corners? No. The things with curved edges do not have corners. So here you write no. Try to find the things which have both straight and curved edges. For example, bicycle, car. Activity time. Take a rectangular sheet of paper. Count its corner. See, now I took a rectangular sheet of paper. See, count its corner. How many corners? The rectangular sheet has 1, 2, 3, 4. Totally 4 corners. What they said? Count its corner. How many corners? 4 corners. Corners, we also tell as vertex. Now, fold one of its corner. Now, I am going to fold one of its corner. See, I fold like this. Already they shown. Now, how many corners does it have now? See, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So totally how many corners? 5 corners. Next, how many corners will you get by folding 2 corners, 3 corners, 4 corners? First, by folding 1 corners, we get how many corners? 5. Now I'm going to folding 2 corners of the paper. Now I'm going to count the corners of the paper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So totally how many corners? 6 corners. Next, how many corners will you get by folding 3 corners? See, already we completed 2 corners. Now I'm going to complete the third corner. Now look at here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So totally how many corners? 7 corners. Next, how many corners will you get by folding 4 corners? Totally how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Totally how many corners? 8 corners. Okay. Next, what they said? Can you fold this paper in such way that it has only 3 corners? You are allowed only 2 folds. See, can you fold this paper in a such way that it has only 3 corners? You are allowed to only 2 folds. Now I take the rectangular sheet. Now I am going to fold. See, now I folded in one folder, again another folded. Look at here. Two folded only. Now the paper has 1, 2, 3 corners, but I fold two folds. Next, what shape will you get? We get triangle. Repeat the activity with a square sheet of a paper. Now, this activity done by rectangular sheet. This activity done by rectangular sheet. You have to done the activity in a square sheet. Look at the next page. Can we fold all the corners of the square sheet in such way the number of corners remains unchanged? The number of corners remains unchanged. What is that? Four corners. In rectangular sheet also we have four corners. In square sheet also we have four corners. Look at the following table and tick the names of things that have corners. Also count the number of edges and corners in each of them. Name of thing, they have a four column. Name of thing, whether it has corners, number of edges, number of corners. Die. Die has a corners? Yes, it has a corner. How many edges it has? 12 edges. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And back side, 3 edges is there. See, now I show that. Now you count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. So totally 12 edges. How many corners? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. 8 corners. Next, ball. No corners. Eraser, it's look like this. Eraser also similar to cube, but eraser is in cuboid shape. It has corners, same, it has 12 edges and 8 corners. Egg, there is no corner. Sheet of a paper, yes, it has corner. How many edges? 4 edges and 4 corners. Next, in the following figures, those which have corners, do these figures have curved lines? In the following figures, take those which have corners, do these figures have the curved lines? See, using the curved line, what are the figures get curved? Here, this one and this one. These two figures are get curved. Remaining also, see here also, corners, here also corners, here also corner, here there is no corner, here also there is no corner, here has corners, here there is no corners. But in the curved line, what are the picture? Only two picture. In this figures, those have corners, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four figures have corners. Next, using only straight lines, can you draw a figure which has no corners? No. Using only straight line, it is not possible to draw the figure that has no corners. Using only one straight line, it is not possible to draw a figure that has no corners. Okay. Here you write no. Turn the next page. Tangram. The tangram is an old Chinese puzzle. From the piece of the tangram, we can make a mini shapes of animals, people and things. At the back of your book, you will find a square like the one in this figure. Cut it out carefully and cut the pieces. The set of 5 pieces is called 5-piece tangram. The set of 7 pieces, that is 7-piece tangram. Use the 5-piece tangram to make the following figures. Using these 5-piece tangram, we can make the following figures. You have to, in the last page, we have like this tangram. So you have to cut it out and try this figures using the tangram. How many triangles do you have in your set, or are all of them equal size? Find out. How many triangles in the set? 1, 2, 5. So here you write 1, 2, 5. Are all of them in equal size? No. No, and equivalent size. Using the two small triangles in the tangram set to get the following shapes. See, using two triangles we can get the following shape. So place the triangle in this way, here one triangle, here one triangle, so we can get a square shape. Here also using two small triangle, see, first triangle we want to place here and second triangle we want to place here. Now this is look like a big triangle. And then next, see, using two triangles we can get this shape. Which two pieces of tangram set are exactly same? See, which two pieces of the tangram set are exactly same? See, 2 and 5, the both are exactly same. So here you write 2 and 5. Take a pieces 4 and 5 from the set. Find out on which side of the triangle you can join the other pieces. See, you have to take the piece 4 and 5. You can join the other pieces. Find out which side of the triangle you can join with the other pieces. So you take the 4 and 5 and make some triangles shapes using the 4 and 5 pieces. Find matching sides among the following pairs of pieces. Find the matching sides among the following sides of pieces. Piece 1 and 2. You have to take piece 1 and 2. We can place the 1 and 2 in this way. Okay. Next, piece 2 and 4. See, piece 2 and 4. You have to cut it out and placed in a correct way. You can get one shape. And piece 1 and 5 also like that. You have to keep the 5 here, then it will give one and shape. Next, piece 2 and 5, this 2 and 5, I think the square shape, these shapes and all you can get using the piece 2 and 5. Next, the 7 piece tangram. Here is the tangram of the 7 piece. You can cut out these pieces and put them together in different ways to make some very interesting shapes. This is a 7 piece tangram. This is also back side of your book. Sorry, back side, not last page of your book. Try making these shapes using the 7 piece tangram. You have to make these shapes. Now, try making the following shapes using only 3 pieces written here. Use only triangles. Using the triangles, how we can get these shapes? See, see, here one triangle, here one triangle, here one triangle, here one triangle. So using 4 triangles we can get this figure. Next, use piece 1, 2, 3 and 5. See, piece number 1, that is one triangle, and piece number 2 also another triangle, and piece number 3 is a parallelogram, and piece number 5 again 5. So we can get the rectangle using the pieces 1, 2, 3 and 5. Use only 2 triangles. See, here one triangle, here one triangle. We can get the square shape. Next, using pieces 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 5. First, I'm going to draw first piece. Next, piece 2, that is big triangle, no? Piece 1, piece 2. Next, piece 3, that is parallelogram. This is piece 3. Next, piece 5, one triangle, and piece 4 is a rectangle. Now using a pieces 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, we can get the square shape. Next, weaving patterns. Do you have any idea about patterns? Pattern is nothing. Any shapes or numbers. Come over and over without any changes. Without any changes, that is called patterns. See, Golu and Binu went to the market with their aunt. They saw many rugs and daris. Daris means rugs. This is our rugs. These rugs are spread out in the hall. Any function, we have to spread the rug. Wow, so many colors, so many shapes. Binu said, so many shapes, circles, triangles. See the patterns. Which geometrical shape can you identify in these borders? Draw them in your notebooks. What are the shapes? Circle, square, This one is regular hexagon and this one is hexagon. Regular hexagon, then curved line, that is arc. Is shape repeating in a particular pattern? Which ones? Yes, the shape is repeating in a particular pattern. See here, square, hexagon, square, hexagon, square, like this. Here also, see, square, circle, here also big circle, small circle. Which one? Mat 1 and 2, the shapes. Which shapes are repeating? Mat 1, 2, 3 and 3. It's of three rugs are, the shapes are repeating in a particular pattern. Other shapes are made of curved line, straight line, both curved and straight line. See, both curve and straight line. Look at your clothes, your mother's saree, shawls, rugs, man mats. Can you identify some patterns? Draw them in your notebook. So look at your clothes, your mother's saree, salwars, and rugs and mats. Can you identify some patterns and draw them in your notebook? Turn the next page. Floor patterns. Have you ever seen a floor which has a design? Have you ever seen a floor which has a design like this? Did you see our pavement in our school? It is the same design. Do you know how these designs are made? These designs are made by covering the floor completely with the small tiles that fit it into each other without any gaps. See, the small tiles that fit it into each other without any gaps. Can you see any gaps between the tiles? No, there is no gap. For example, look the shape of the tile and see how it fits. See, here this curve, they both will fit into each other. Now look at this tile with sides. See, this is a regular hexagon. Regular hexagon. It has how many sides? Edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 edges. How many corners? 6 corners. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 corners. 6 edges, 6 corners. See how tiles of the shape can cover the floor completely without any gaps. Why? Because the all sides are in equal length. So it can fit it the floor completely without any gaps. Look at the next page. Among the following, can you match the tiles with the designs that they will make on the floor? Draw lines to match. See, here this tile, one tile is hexagon. Here, which is hexagon? Here, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So draw a line. Next, look at the second tiles.
It is in square shape. See, here we have two square shaped tiles. But look at the design. The design is match with this tile. And third one, this is also square tile. Here remaining, which is the square tile? This one. So, you can match like this. Next, this is a triangle tile. At last, you can match this. Next, you can also make your own tiles and use them to make your own tiling patterns. You will find some such tiles at the end of the book that you can cut out, trace and color. Complete the following tiling pattern. So you have to complete the following tiling pattern using these two colors. Turn the next page. Complete this pattern. Complete it with the pattern on a page 70, which also uses a 6 sides shapes. What is the difference between two? See, in the 70th page, here also they used hexagon, but here they used only these shapes, 6 side shapes. But here they used 6 side shapes and then they used triangle tile to complete the floor pattern. Here also using these two colors you have to complete the pattern. Next, Khushbu and Harris live in Agra. One day they went to see a Taj Mahal. The floor had the pattern shown below. I can see two different tiles in this pattern. Khushbu said, I can see two different tiles in this pattern. But Harris said, I think only one type of tile has been used. What do you think? Discuss with your friends. Yes, Harris said correctly, they used only one type of tile, but in different manner. See, but in different manner. One in horizontal and one tile in vertical. Okay. Next, tiling time. The patterns below are made from this tile. In this pattern, three colors have been used to make it look like steps. See, one, two, this is look like a steps. Using three colors, they made this pattern, it look like a steps. By using two colors, it becomes a different patterns, blue and yellow flowers. See, it is look like a blue and yellow flowers. Next, use a different color combination to make your own patterns. Here, use a different, apart from these two, these colors, have to different colors combination to make your own pattern. Then one answered, I have seen a mithai. Mithai means sweet, of these shapes. Have you seen these shapes in any other design on a wall, a dress, on a basket, a mat, etc.? If you have seen any other shape, any other design in a wall or a dress, have to write here. Thank you, students.